To work with null values, let's imagine that you need to keep track of a student's score and then display it to the screen. If the student hasn't taken the test, then the value should be null. We'll create a object of type int that is named score. Notice that I'm not declaring a value here, which means that it will be null. The first thing we'll do is write it to the console. And I'm going to insert a console.read key to make it pause at the end of the debugger. So we'll debug it now. Now notice that the compiler gives me an error, use of unassigned local variable score. By default, you can't simply reference a variable that hasn't had a value assigned to it. If you want something to be nullable, in C#, you can use the nullable generic. We'll discuss generics in a later lesson, but for now, just know that you use the class nullable and you put the type that you want to use in angle brackets, exactly as I've done here. Now, I will define the value, but I will define the value as null. So let's try to run this again. Now, notice that it comes back and displays score and then nothing. That's because the value was null. It didn't cause an error. It simply didn't have a value to display. That's probably not the results that we want. Instead, we probably need some sort of logic that checks to determine whether the score is actually null. We can check the nullable.hasValue property. So if it has a value, we'll write it to the screen. If it doesn't have a value, we'll just write a generic message saying no score yet. Let's try that again. And as you can see, because we haven't defined a score, it comes back with no score yet. Now let's imagine that we actually define a score. I'll run it one more time, and this time it should simply, it'll have a value, so the first if statement will come back as true, and then it will successfully display the score.